Alright, so here's the tool that I could be using. Fill up flathead to remove the cluster. You're soldering. This one is the Ryobi. You can buy any kind you want. You'll get the one that connects to the outlet or the one that corners. It's up to you. I bought the Ryobi because I have all the tool and battery already. So it's better to use the smaller tips. This one I'm just using the standard one that came with it. Next could be a sponge or a steel wool. So based on my research, it is very important to keep your tip super clean. So from what I watch and learn, keeping your tip very clean is very important. Next is make sure you're using the correct solder. So you see, I'm using the electrical Rosin Core. So this is very important. Make sure you get, well, at least for me, I'm using this one, this brand. I mean, not brand, this type of solder. This one, I believe, will have flux and stuff in it. So you could just do it and that's it. So yeah, use any kind of one, but the main thing is, I mean, you can use any brand you want. Main thing is, make sure it's Rosin Core solder. This one above my local autozone. Everything here above for local Home Depot, autozone, home, to whatever. Next could be the type of LED. The type you need is PLCC2. There are different brands, the Lighthouse, Osimium, a bunch of other brands. Next, you need a tweezer, just optional. But you use it. And it's how the LED look like, very small. So the brand I'm going to be using is Osimium. So this one is brighter than a Lighthouse. At least in person, it's brighter. This is how the LED look like, let me zoom in. It's super small, like very small. So if you want to test the light on the LED light, this is just a cheap hopper frame multimeter, negative here, positive here. You go to the 200 distance, turn it on, and then just test it out. And then should light up. Oh, like open. Like this. Just like that. You have to test it out. It's up to you. But yeah. So yep, that's pretty much all the tool I can be using. Alright, so to remove the gate cluster, this is do a screw. So on the bottom panel on the steering wheel. This how it look like. So be one here, one right here, and one here. Just total three. So 1, 2, 3. And you can see, I'm gonna zoom and just fill up screwdriver for all three. So I do just unscrew it and just remove the trimmer setting and then just remove the panel piece. So it'll be two part. This will be one part and the top will be the second part. And then once you remove it, I just use the instruction cut. It's suck this out and this should be it. Alright, so once you remove the two screw, next gonna be moving this pen, this plastic piece. So what I'll let you do, I'll put this one here. So I'll put my trim to my hair. Let's crack it open. That. And then just, that's one side. Then same thing on the other side. Top piece up, put the low piece, load this thing down, and just lay up. One, doing with one hand while holding the, my phone. But something like this, pretty much. So just using it, and that's it. Once you remove the plastic piece, that's gonna be removing the two screws. So just optional, I'll just take this thing out. The screw would be right there. Why not that? It'd be, where is it? This one. So that's one. But then the other one would be, oh, that's one here. So one and two. That's it. So what's wrong with the two screws? I can use a suction cup to stick it and then pull it out. Alright, now that the two screws out, we could be taking out the cluster and using a suction cup. So first you do, you lower down your steering wheel all the way down. And then just stick on it. I'll try to do this with one hand. And then just pull it. So once stuck on it, you pull it and it should come out just like that. You see it's out now. So I can't record it, the next part, because I'm doing it one hand. So I can pull it out, pull this out, unplug the wire. So now I unplug the wire, so it's easier to start the one on the right and then do the one left. So when you plug it, push on this down, put this one down too. So you could move it all the way out, just slide like that. As you can see, you could do it without removing your stereo. It's easier to remove your stereo, but I don't, because it's an extra step, you can see. So I'll let you do the white one first and then the left one. Because the white one is a bit shorter than the left one, you can see. The left one is way longer compared to the one on the right. So let's do this one first, so this will be loose, and then just take it out. Next, I'm gonna be removing the cluster, taking the cluster apart. Okay, so the first step to removing your lens, and you take out this thing, just pull out. That's it. The lens, you have two screws. One, two. So two fill up and that's it. The rest can be tap in. And then just tap, that's it. So you got total of six tap and two screw. One. So very important, make sure you do not lose your screw. You put the tab out, you'll be pulling out. It'd be easier if it's two people, but it's possible to do solo. Now all the tab all out, you can see. Let's focus on this tab. All I'm gonna do is push it out. Okay, just be gentle so I don't break any tab. And just like that. The lens out, now you can clean it, polish it, everything. So now this is out. So now the cluster is wide open. Also, so make sure you don't lose your thing. Alright, so next gonna be removing the needle. So again, I can use my trend tool. I could just pop it in here and just pop it out. So I'm gonna give you a super close look. Just pop it in here and gently. Just like that. like that. And it just blew off. Alright, so now that your needle has been removed, this part could be optional. Pinning your needle, taking apart, you could do it. So if you want to remove this piece, right, a pin a different color, I'm assuming. So this is how it looks like, right? What you have to do is break these two tabs. You just break it, right? Just get screwed and just break it. With a whatever tool you want, you could just break the tab. And then once it comes loose, the needle come loose. Once the needle come loose, the bottom part you can see right here. Except this part is shiny. This part is clear. And this part is just matte. You sand down so it be clear. That's up to you though. I'm not sure guys do that because I'm not gonna do it in this one. That could be pinning this piece. So this piece is super easy. Just that, and the other side, that. Super easy. So you want to paint it in one, that. See, I did so easily. Like that. Now off for your, this thing is out now. The next step would be moving the black piece. So it'll be this pure hand, which I did this one. So I'll just grab it, or I can use my, use a trim tool. As you can see, it only have two tab. That's it, just two tab. Got that. Closer look. Just like that. You see. Just two tap. That's it. One here. One here. Don't mind my nail or my finger. This one. Same thing. So the reason why I had to move the needle and this thing. So now that you remove the needle and the black holder thing. Next, you're going to unscrew this and that, I'm assuming. Just unscrew that. This could be a 716. You just unscrew it, which I did already. Take that up. So the back have a ton of a screw, which could be Phillips. So I'll start from left to right, one here, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So four on the bottom, and then four on the top. So I could do just a screw on it. Just two. Be the last one, number 8. So, in case you're wondering, the screw on the back on the same one that was holding the top, so it's somewhat if you mix them. Just an FYI, in case you accidentally mix the screw up, then that's fine. Next, let me zoom out just like I could see. So, let me open it. Now that you remove the needle, the black thing, the 8 screw in the back. Next here, there could be 4 tab. One on here, one over here, and 2 that's holding your mileage. This thing. So first start with this 2. Put this down. Punch it up. So once these two go in, do the one on the side. Like Let me just zoom in guy on a tab. So that's the tab right there. And we're out on the unscrew area, but there we go. Just like that. So now the base is by itself now. Next what you do, so there's the back. You want to put this back in here. Like that. Just so it does this fly away. Now the face is now separated. So I'm gonna put this on the side. So this one I moved the nut so it could separate it, because if you remove this nut, it just gets stuck hanging. You could do it without removing the nut, which could hang it, but there's no point in doing that. So here's how it looks like. So first thing I can do is remove this thing. Like that. See, here's the mileage. Put that in the same spot. And you have an LED. So next will be explaining what each LED do. Alrighty. So you take out everything. Now time to swap the LED. But now you do know which one's which. So here's just a quick guide. Keep this next to you so you know. So you're gonna see which bulb is which. So the most common one you can be switching is the whole gauge cluster. So I'm gonna show the one that you can be switching. So first can be the temperature. The temperature and the gas are the same. So the one that's sideways, which is this one, and the one for here. These two are gonna be the one that light up the gauge and the needle. So this closer look and see. It's sideways, so this one. And so it's sideways. Those two are gonna be the temperature and your gas. Next gonna be your relay and your speed. So it could be full bulb. It'd be just two here. So here's your needle. Right next to your needle. So the two bulbs right next to your needle would be your gauge. The only thing about the gauge is that let's see. You see how to check. Yep. So this part would be your red light. So it's these two. It's for your gauge. This would be your red light. Would be the 8 to 9k RPM. As you can see, so that would be your red light, I believe. Yeah. Alright. That's why it's so important to look. Take your time, compare. Yep. So this can be your red light. See, next gonna be, so this power here gonna be your e-brake. If you're not sure, you can just look at the side. Not you, yep, you can see it. Starting to move just the light. You can see on here, you got your e-brake, your high beam, your signal, your cruise control, ABS, SRS bag, your side airbag. So all you do is just line up the LED bulb to each one. So your e-brake, high beam, signal, what's this, cruise control, ABS, your airbag, your side airbag. Your legacy sign, your maintenance light, your ignition key, maintenance light, ignition key, your oil, check engine light, battery, oil, check engine light, and then your battery. And then this one is just your alarm when you lock the key. When you lock the car. There's gonna be your when you lock gas, when your doors open, when you need your seatbelt. Gas, doors open, seatbelt. That's pretty much, let me get simple on it. These three will be your mileage. So those three will be light up your whole mileage. So these three, because one is the background, one is when you turn on car. So when you turn on car with no light, it'll be brighter. When you turn the switch, it'd be dimmer. So that's why you have three light bulbs, in case you want to be. So that's pretty much it for all the LED. Alright, so before you remove the old one, here's the new one. So this for the 0506 type best custom. The negative will be on top, and the positive will be on the bottom. So you see the logo, right? You see the V. So the V pointing up is your negative, and then the straight line is a positive. So this one will be the new one. So this will be the new one. So you will be installing the same way as is on here. So for everything that's straight up, you'll be facing making a V pretty much. So for the side, so for like your gas, your temperature, and your mileage, it's on the side, so it be look like this. So it be a look like that. So it will be a opposite C. So for the side, it look like this way, so it'll be pointing not this way, but this way. So for the mileage and everything else, it'll point this way. So opposite of the letter C. So once you have an idea of which one negative, which one positive, that's gonna be taking it out and installing a new one. So I'll be showing you guys two angle and wide angle view and a close view. Okay, so now that you know which LED bulb you're going to change, we can start removing the LED. All you can need is just heat up your soldering pin, your tweezer, that's it, and your sponge. That's all you need. You're not gonna use this yet, it's only for connecting. So all you need is your sponge, your clean tip, or steel wool, and your tweezer, that's it. So what we're gonna do, just heat up the side and this side, and while you're heating it up, it'll be loose and then you tweeze it out. So I'll show you a wide angle view and a close view. So if this is your first time doing it, when you're doing it might take a while. You feel like it's not heated up. It is. It just take like a few seconds or so. So just take your time. So here's a super close look. I try my best to not block it, but it's kind of hard to do, to be honest. Alright, now I'm just going to switch here. Go back and forth. And that's it. And then put this on the way. And then next, you make sure you clean your, just clean your needle. And that's pretty much it. You can see I just removed the two. Now I do the same thing to whatever light bulb you want to switch, and then you can change start a new one. You install your new LED. So this is how it looks like. The two ways you open it. One way is just poke through the back. You can see the back has some hole. You could just poke through it. Or you could do what I did. Just remove the sheet, the plastic, and then just do that. So if you have a lot like this, you could just cut it, and then that way you don't lose. That way you don't accidentally peel the whole thing, and then you can lose it all. But yeah, that's pretty much. So I'm gonna remove one, and then get ready to install it. So now you grab your flux, and flux your soldering, make it straight and line. Let you make it long, like it's a pencil, like that. Get your pin ready. I mean, sorry. Clean the tip again. Make sure the tip is clean. And now we're gonna start installing your new LED. So I'll be showing you again two view, wide angle and close view. So remember to install the light within negative and positive. So for the offset with 6 type S, you'll be installing V shape. So facing up. So what you want to touch the solder and the metal piece together at the same time, if possible. That's it for the right angle. Next be a closed view. So now I'm gonna start a new one. So I am not a pro at this, nor do am I consider myself an expert. I consider myself as a newbie. I barely know anything, but I did this once and it worked, and pretty much just how I did it. So the way I did it, it might not be 100% correct, but yeah. Anyway, so you'll be installing a new one. Make sure the negative is on top, the positive is on bottom. You may be making a V shape. So what I do, once you remove it, before you install a new one, I let you add some solder in it in the beginning, or only on one side. Just so it could stick onto it. So again, just the way I do it. But yeah, so make sure your tip is heated up and clean, and just start soldering. So what you can do is make contact with the solder. So you want to make contact with the solder and the metal piece at the same time. So imagine I'm soldering, right? So look like this, right? So you want to tap right in the middle, right? So tap right in the middle. So do not tap on the solder only. Do the metal and the solder together. So let's just try that. Alright, that's it. Put it on here. So once you put on here, next you can heat up. So this already soldered on here already. So no need to add any more unless you need some more. So I'm gonna put on here, heat up the solder and the metal piece together. You can see this metal piece right on the side. That's where you connect it to. So make sure it's correct on correct side, positive, positive, negative, negative. Slightly by pushing down. Like that. So clean your tips. So next you do the back side. So now you have to add solder in it. So the first one, you did it while the LED is not installed yet. And then the second one, you have to add solder in it. So here's alright, so that's is how much I do. So this is how my look like. You see, definitely not the best. So that's how my look like. Show the back. That's the back. That's what it look like. So again, I'm not a pro, but pretty much you connect. We connect that, so you want the metal and the solder to connect as one piece, like that. So mine looks super ugly, but that's pretty much the general idea of how you do it. So I can show you another closer look. Alright, so this one gonna be the temperature. Gonna be another closer look. So this one is sideways. So it make a opposite of the letter C. So take your tip. Right, tweezer. And just move. So do not install the lens yet. All you're doing is just testing out. So I also installed the needle. Just so I can see if the needle light up or not. So do not worry about recalibrating or anything like that yet. All you can do right now is test out the light. Make sure the light as it light up. That's pretty much it. So we're gonna plug in and then connect your battery again and test it out. Alright, so now we're gonna test the light. So connect your wire, connect your battery. One thing you should do before plugging this in, and make sure you rotate this clockwise, all the way to all the way to the brightness. The smile was all the way to the left, and it wasn't that bright. but it turned out the switch I didn't change up. So again, now you're just testing light, you're not recalibrating or anything like that, so don't worry about having the lens or anything. All you do right now is just testing the light, make sure it works. So all I do, just press, click on the switch and test that out. You see all my lights working. So tap, attack, the needle spray. Yep, that's it. Emergency light, the signal, yeah, blue. So now I'm gonna turn on the car to make sure the e-brake light light up. And if you like me, make sure you put the wiper back off. Alright, so the brake light is working. Oh crap. So the brake light is working. That's working. You can see like that. So I turn it back on. That's it. Detect the signal. Working. That's pretty much it. Alright, so now that you tested everything, it is working all good. It could be pretty much install AD back. So the first step, you put this back on here. Don't screw it yet. Next would be installing the mileage. Make sure you clean it, which must not clean. Wipe it off. So you can see this is a needle, this is a 3-hole. The 3-hole is for your light bulb. And the needle is going inside this black thing. You see, so I did it line up. Just like that. And then I push in. There'll be 2 tap. And that's it. Alright, so next thing can be installing the nut. So it could be taken on the plate. So for me, I just take out just this side only. You could take out the whole thing if you want. I'm not. So I can put this straight in. Lift it up. Push it down here. Up everything. Like that. Make sure everything is flat. Like that. So this I'm not sure. I'm not sure if the washer should be underneath or top. I'm just gonna put it on top, but I might do it wrong. Make sure I forgot. Do you check on your first or where the washer should be at? I'm not gonna check, so next you can just screw it in. Again, the size is 7 by 16. I believe that's by metric. Screw it tight. Just snug it. Don't need to use your ratchet, make it tight, just snug it with bare hand. Alright, so next we'll be installing the black piece. So there'll be two different ones if you notice. One the big one like this. Okay. Then one the small one like this. So the big one, go to your tag in your speed. It's just flat. Don't push it too hard. It could be your small one. Right, so one thing about the gas and the temperature. So the bigger one, you know any pattern, you can start anywhere you want. But for temperature, you can see how one side got the gap line and put it. See how you got the gap right here? So the way you install it, you want the gap to be on the bottom. And then you want the part where so you want it to install it this way. Not this way, okay? Not this way. But this way. So with the open area is facing the bottom. Like that. If it's not the other way, it shouldn't fit in. Don't try to force it. If you try to force it, that means you did it incorrectly. So again, the time you start, it's that way so the needle can move around. Because if you start the other way, the needle will be moving this way. Right? So next, you're pretty much going to be starting the needle now. So the needle, you push right. Make sure you line up. So make sure you line up between the hole and the needle. Just line up. You can't see it because I'm doing it. So do not push it down yet. Again, do not push down yet. Just slide it. Alright, so now I can push it down. So by pushing down, right, make sure you line up with the bottom. So not all the way here. So again, have you pushed it down yet? It's just, all I did just slide it. So you line up with the E, and then you just push it down. Now it's down, just leave it. So do this one. Slide down. Push it down. Okay. And that's it. So pretty much onto everything. Just leave it on the bottom like that. So I'm gonna show you the review. That's how it should look like. That one here, that one there. That the C, that E, and right. So next step, before you install your good screen, gonna be when you're installing your trims. Alrighty, so next step before you install your lens, you're gonna screw in the 8 screw that you did. Next, going to clean your lens, which I did mine already. Slide down. Make sure it clip, lock. Now the end is locked. The screen is two screws on top. So make sure you is this way. Just slide it. That's it. Make sure you twist it, yep. It is working. Can you press it out? Yep. That's pretty much it. Alright, so the last step is going to be recalibrating your needle. So to fix any needle issue, just in case. But one thing that I will note, the moment you connect your wire, if your needle isn't in the correct place, so like mine is not correct, except for the RPM, it's a little bit off. The way you fix it, you have to disconnect the wire, take out the needle again, put it back in, turn all register max clockwise until you turn them more, connect the wire. The moment you connect the wire, the needle will go to whichever spot you go. So let's say it goes to 3K RPM, you move the needle until it hit the zero, and then disconnect the wire, connect your lens again, and then connect the wire again, and then make sure it is correct. So after all your needle is in the correct spot, next one can be recalibrating. To recalibrate your needle, to be 5 steps. Step one, insert your key. Step two, don't turn on your light all the way. Step three, you hold your trip meter, hold it. Step four, turn on your ignition. Step five, turn off and on your light 2 times. So turn off one, turn back on, turn it off. Press the trip meter 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. And turn on. So now we do it fast. So turn your ignition, turn the light, press your trip meter. Turn your ignition. Off, on, off, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you just do it not fast, but a bit little fast, not super slow, and it still fixes itself. You can see the mixture aiding is maxed out. Once it finish, just turn off, double check everything. Zero E. Again, this one's a bit off until you fix it. To start the car, make sure you pump gas full before you do this, by the way. I did say that. And the gas meter should be max. Yep. So that should be max. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So hopefully you guys like this this video. So this is how it looks like. Next is gonna be a clip of how it looks like at night time. So here is the final result. And that's pretty much how my gate cluster look like. Blue with my stock red needle because I didn't paint it or anything. Turn the ignition. ADL is stock right beside the e-brake and the signal, as you can see. I'm gonna show you when how the mileage look like. That's how it look like when the light car is off. I mean the light is off. That's pretty much it. Pretty much done with my cluster. So the only thing I haven't done yet is the mirror switch and the power window. But I think I can leave it red just to match with the needle. But that's pretty much it. I might make this red too. The AC, the one in the middle. Turn it red to match the needle too, but we'll see, to be honest. But that's pretty much it. I'll show you a video on how to make change your time control already. Now you have a video on swapping your LED cluster. So this is for the 0506, the 02, 03, 04, and I'm thinking it's almost the same thing. But yeah, anyway, that's pretty much it. So like, comment, subscribe to see more content. Next video can maybe either my stereo or my fog light. I was looking at other YouTube video on fog light, and I think I might make one. Normally, I try not to make a video that someone make already, but it's so late in the night, my mind is drifting away. Then I dream about times I wished for a new, happier day. If a hand could reach out. Face.